Hello friends, myself Preeti Desai. Welcome to Path to Success channel. Today we are going to see how to read the Hindu newspaper for UPSC or some state service examinations. As we all know that reading Hindu is a very crucial part, very crucial stage in the preparation of the competitive examinations, especially UPSC or other state examinations. So, but many times students have the question that how to read Hindu, how much time to be devoted for reading Hindu, right? So for this I have made some bullet points that what's under what section Hindu news are covered and which section we have to focus more, which section we have to neglect completely. So this is what I'm going to discuss in this video, right? So let us begin with the national news section. National news will be first page of the Hindu and second page of the Hindu, which is to be read. And these are important news. Okay, the second one is the north, east, west, south. So this is basically the state's news coverage, which we can completely skip, or we have to be judged here in this section, that we have to decide that which news is important from the examination point of view. If suppose some state scheme is there, analysis of some state scheme is given, we can read it, we can give it as an example, or it can be even asked in the pre-examination also, right? So this section, you have to decide which news you have to read, which you have to skip, right? Fine. So this is not that important. The next comes is the editorial. Editorial is very important in the Hindu newspaper. This is written by the editor of the Hindu, and there are two editorials every day. You will have the two editorials, except Sunday. Sunday also editorials are there. No, except Sunday. Fine. So two editorials are there. They are like very authenticate information and opinion based analysis of the topic is given. So this can be directly used for your answer writing, right? And the next is the op-ed. This is an open editorial. Open editorial is two open editorials are there every day. So these are quite lengthy, but I will recommend that you have to go through this op-ed because this is really very important. From mains point of view, this is covering the IR topics, international relation topics, and most of the time these op-eds are written by the foreign ambassadors or ex-diplomats and some scholarly, these are really scholarly articles, so they are directly useful for your examination. Two op-eds are there, so I will recommend this is very important. Fine. Then you have the letters to editor, which you can skip. This is not required at all. Fine. Then you have the political. Next section is the political news. Political news, again, like this, you will have to be judged here. That you have to decide which news is to be read, which news has to be skipped, because all news are not important. The news related to the election, expenditure, and whatever. So those news you can simply skip, that are not required. Nobody is going to ask you in your examination those type of news, right? Which state is having election on which date, and that kind of news should be skipped completely. But there are certain news which you have to read. So which news are those, right? So those are the, like, some court judgment is given, so you will have to read that court judgment. Fine. You will have to note it down, because the basic point in reading Hindu is only reading will not suffice. Along with reading, you will have to make some short notes of Hindu reading. Fine. After reading the Hindu, you will have to make the notes, then and then only it will be helpful. Otherwise it will not be helpful. You will not be able to recollect, or you will not be able to revise it at the time of examination, before the examination, right? So if you have some court judgment, if there is some critical analysis related to the government welfare schemes like PEHEL or NAREGA, that you will have to read it and you will have to note it also, right? Then if there is some survey, like Pratham is an NGO which is in the section of education, it conducts survey. So those type of news are there in this political news section of Hindu. So you will have to read them. Fine. So you have to be selective here. Fine. The next one is the world news. World news section of Hindu. Most of the PT questions which are related to the world sections are covered in this. If you are reading this with open eyes, right, then you will be able to solve all the questions of UPSC in this section, especially in the pre. And even in the mains. Fine. So here For example, in this year's examination, there was a question related to THAAD missile system. Which country does it belong to? So it belongs to US. This was covered widely in the Hindu newspaper in this section. Then Trafalgar Square, where is this square? It is in UK. And this type of news are there in this world news section. Fine. And the names of cities under ISIS, this is just for example. The names of cities under ISIS control. This type of questions, you will never ever get it in any books or any magazine. Fine. Only Hindu will give you. So you have to be continuously reading this. I'm not recommending to read it in detail, but you just have to have a glance at it and note down whatever is required from the examination point of view. So you have to be very, very selective in this section also. The next one is the business page. The business page coverage of Hindu is average level itself. I will not recommend it very highly. So you just have to have a glance at whatever news are there in this page. Fine. And if somebody wants a thorough coverage of the business news of the country, then they can go for other newspaper like Mint or Financial Express. Hindu doesn't have a wide coverage of business news. Only just one page is dedicated to it. Next is the business review. It is just next to the business page. Fine. Here in the business review, sometimes the financial policies are analyzed and they are discussed in a very detail, and it's very good for mains paper 3. So you here again you have to see that which topic of this is relating to your syllabus, like paper 3 syllabus, or any of the topic of any of relating to your any of topic in your syllabus. Fine. So for reading Hindu, you have to be thorough with your syllabus also. This is very important. The next is the sports section. Sports section, this is not that important for UPSC, but from the point of view of the states examination, state service examinations, they tend to ask it in their pre-examination that they will give the name of the sports person and which sports does he play or which sports does she play. Fine. So for this reason, you can just have a glance at the picture of the picture of the sports person and the name. And which sports does that sports person play, or any tournament going on in country or outside, that you can just make a note of it. It will be helpful. Fine. So this is also you have to just have a glance at it. So these are major topics or major sections of Hindu which are covered. So apart from these topics which are covered regularly, daily basis, there are certain other sections also in Hindu which comes on a particular day. Like there is opportunities page, which comes on Wednesday. This opportunities page is covering basically the career job related opportunities and that articles related to that. So this is basically helpful in ethics paper. Paper 4 you can use them directly because there are certain topics which are related to our syllabus of paper 4, like work culture, attitude, aptitude, right? So it will be helpful in that way. Then there are certain which is very good. This is new section which is started by Hindu, which comes on Friday. That is opinion based topics. One topic will be there, and that topic, three people's opinion will be taken. One person will be in favor of it, one person will be against that topic, and one person will give you a midway to that topic. So it is a very good discussion and opinion. It's a very good fodder for the mains writing, answer writing. So I will recommend that this section has to be read goodly. And the next section is the ground zero, which comes on Saturday. This ground zero section, in which Hindu covers one topic thoroughly. On one page, one topic is discussed in a very much detail. And this is particularly useful for writing essay. You will get a lot of examples. Like topics covered in this are like Kerala disaster or some social legal practices which are still continuing in India, malnutrition. So it really goes into the details of the topic. So it is very important. So this also you can give a read. Fine. The next you have a science and technology which comes on a Sunday. So this is important for pre and mains both, but all the topics in this section are not to be read. Only selectively you will have to read, right? And make a notes of it. That is very important. Again and again, I am emphasizing on that point. The next is this on Sunday, book review comes. this section I will not recommend it for all. Only those people who are having book reading as a hobby, or those who want to give book reading as a hobby in their DAF. The DAF is the one thing which you will have to fill once you are qualifying the pre. So before mains, you have to fill the form DAF, in which you have to mention which are your hobbies. So if you are planning to give book reading as your hobby, or you have already your book reading as a hobby, so you can read this. You are getting the review of the newly published books. So otherwise, for other people, it is not relevant at all. You can just skip that. The next thing, apart from the main newspapers, Hindu also gives some supplements. So in the supplement, in the Delhi section, Delhi Hindu, we are getting Delhi Metro, which comes every day, which is not relevant. Local news are discussed in detail, so that is not important from the point of view of the competitive examination. The next is a Friday review. Friday review is also not important for UPSC and other state service aspirants. Then comes a magazine, which comes on Sunday. So magazine, one cover story is there on the magazine. So this cover story, if you find it interesting, you can read it. But this is very important for, this is very good for essay again, a fodder for essay, right? You can get a lot of examples out of it, and you can make notes of it, right? You make a notes of it if you want, right? It will be, actually it will give you the edge when you are writing an essay. So this magazine is also like, if you want, you can read. And those who are very fond of traveling, there is some travel blog, there is a food blog also. So that thing, a food blog, so those things you can read in this magazine. Then there is a literary review. Again, this is not important from the examination point of view. So overall, this is the analysis of what Hindu covers and what topics we have to read, which are important. So most of the times, students ask that how much time should it take for reading a Hindu. So it again depends upon that, for how many, for how long you are reading Hindu. If you are reading it for 1.5 years, then you are very much thorough with Hindu and the language of Hindu. You are very much accustomed to it. But if you are a fresher, you will require around 1.5 hour for reading Hindu and all the section thoroughly. And for a regular reader of Hindu, if you are reading it for 1 and 2 years, so it is requiring around 35 to 40 minutes for covering the Hindu. So, but again, I will emphasize that you have to read Hindu and you have to make notes of it so that you can retrieve at the time of examination. You can revise before the examination. So, I thank you, friends. I hope this video would have helped you in understanding how to read Hindu newspaper. And if you have not subscribed to the Path to Success channel, please subscribe it and share the video as much as you can, and like the video. Thank you.